Unbelievable, my wonderful people. You'll be shocked too. As an APGA chieftain says, the seat at home order is a plot to make Peter Obi lose election in the southeast. He said it is politically driven. Don't think that there are some people, and it's been pegged on IPOB. Don't think that there are some people who are calling this seat at home order that it is a plot. Since they know that Peter Obi is coming on board, they are trying to use some people. Even when IPOB said, we don't have a hand in it, so don't listen to the people, it is still being carried out. He said, what do you think is going on? That it is politically driven. And is mentioning some very, very serious name, which you'll be shocked about. So these are things happening. A chieftain of APGA, not a Labour Party, not PDP, APGA, the very party of Charles Soludo, the governor of Anambra State. It says this is the plot going on. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Let's get all the details. The All Progressive Grand Alliance APGA senatorial candidate in Ebonyi South Zone, Ifeanyi Elojo, has said that the seat at home order in the southeast states of the Federation is politically driven and a plot against the emergence of the presidential candidate of the Labour Party, Peter Obi. According to him, how would Obi win in the region if the constant seat at home order hinders movement weeks to election? The senatorial candidate argued that it couldn't be a coincidence that the issue of seat at home order was most impacted Ebonyi and Imo states, which are the two All Progressive Congress region in the state, in the country. Late Nigeria gathered that the APGA chieftain associates that there might be a collision between the incident, because for the first time the region is producing a presidential candidate who is a major contender. The senatorial candidate advised that it is very unfortunate that this is, because I have had to try to reckon myself with some of the things happening and going on with Simeon Ekpe. I think he's a misguided fellow, and even the governor of Anambra State. I don't believe they are acting alone. And I will tell you, this is no coincidence at all. The issues and everything going on to hinder movement in the southeast region, it is a coincidence. Is it a coincidence that such issue is most impacted in Ebonyi and in Imo states, which is APC states today? I tell you something, check the ties and watch very well. They are making the people afraid, and you can see Ebonyi and Imo are the states most threatened, and all the issues of IPOB activities are being recorded. People, now the matter when the day ground be that, so when you look at everybody, they look for himself, everybody try to save in himself. Everybody try to save in yourself. So this guy is saying that the issue of what is on ground, that you are saying that this thing is biggest in these two states, Ebonyi and Imo, and they are APC states. According to him, he smells some rats. And he's saying that even the governor of Anambra State is not acting alone against Peter Obi. This is an APGA senatorial candidate that is speaking this. So it's not a Labour Party senatorial candidate. That should tell you that, you know, like the Bible says, it said the enemy of a man's house, the enemy of a man are those of his own household. You know, say the rat when he did bush, no, say you roast fish for fire. Now the one he did, as Nigel call like, say, see you, no, be smarty the apple, so groove they say, where did I say they my ass? What's the apple? So they do fish down. No? Nigel call others, come to me, they do party on top of your fish head. You know, they see what it happens. So it is what it is, to be quite candid. It's just a very big shame that, you know, will I call it a shame? I don't want to say it's a shame. I just feel that the people of the southeast, probably they don't trust that Peter Obi is qualified. I want to see it in an objective manner. Maybe they don't trust that he's qualified. You know, even people from his own very state are trying to, you know, whatever he has done that he has been using as a campaign to, they say, I should not use it to, what did he do? Blah, 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 blah. He didn't do anything. So when you look at it, you're asking yourself very serious question, like, seriously, Peter Obi offend you? This is the first time in a long time that somebody from the Southeast will be a major contender. I'm not saying it's the only time. I said first time in a long time. And we don't know when this is going to happen again. So that somebody from the Southeast is a major. There are 18 people. But tell me truly, how many people name you know? Be honest. Maybe the other person are like your brother or your uncle, your cousin. How many you know in name? Make a couple people say that they're popular for this matter. If you know them, but maybe I don't know them. We don't know them like that. But we know the 18 people. But the ones where they're popular as concerning this matter, number one, we know Peter Obi. And Peter Obi, if you look at all odds, not supposed to be popular as they popular, but because the people accept and come make a popularity swear. So Peter Obi, Tinubu, Atiku, Rabbi Okwonkoso, Omoyele Sowore. Who again? Okay, Abiola's son because of his father. That's how many? 6 out of 18. We had the remaining 12. You do understand what they talk so? So, I mean, if other parts of the country can be accepting your brother and they can see that, oh, he did well or he's going to do well, or they could see the prospect, how come you can't see it? Like I said, I want to see it objectively that probably they feel that Peter Obi is not competent or we are not seeing what they are saying. If you get what I mean, I don't know how to, I don't know how to speak the English. However it is very important that every single person is given an opportunity to pick the presidential candidate they deem fit. You must pick the person you feel has the best potential for us all. In that way, in that manner, the sky is not the limit. It's not the limit. It is just a stepping stone. We just start the matter now. Should not be smarty the apple, so it just the start now. So that's what it is at the moment. These are some of the things that are going on. And why again and again, every single person must ensure that we do everything humanly speaking possible and bring this country to the desired position of moving forward. Moving forward is not an option. It's a reality that must come to be. Every single person must work at it. Everybody must commit to it so that together we can achieve it. That's it. Together. It is the together that's the most important thing. The together. We must achieve it to get together. So these are some of the things that are happening and why again and again we must look at things more objectively and ensure that, we are not being coerced by some people or being let down by yoga. We are allowing some people to just bamboozle us on every side and we just watch on. No, we can't do that. Okay, we can't do that. So it is what it is. And it is important that we make this decision together. Okay, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. God bless. Bye for now.